Hi, I'm Daryl Cagle, and I'm starting a new drawing today. Today's drawing is probably going to do two drawings right now in the same sitting. It's going to be Hillary Clinton trying to finally nail Bernie Sanders into the coffin, and Donald Trump finally trying to nail Cruz and Kasich into the coffin. So two matching cartoons, and in fact, I kind of have a tradition of these Nail the Coffin cartoons going on. This one is 8 years ago when you can see what a terrible early Obama I used to have. It took me a while to get used to him and stop drawing his eyes as little dots. Little dot eyes are kind of a cartooning crutch for get away without drawing the eyes. And at that time, that's what I was doing with Obama, so I am not proud of that Obama, but hey, it is what it is. It worked at the time. As you will recall, Hillary was very slow to get out of the presidential race, so there's a bit of irony in her saying the same thing about Bernie. And then 16 years ago, I drew this one with terrible-looking President Bush. That was before I had learned to draw President Bush, or that President Bush had taken on his cartoon persona. Terrible-looking President Bush. But, hey, this is my history. What can I do? How can I ignore history? So, today I'm going to draw the same friggin' cartoon, because it seems like every 4 years this is a recurring theme. I'm going to do the cartoon facing this way because I think the gag is you look and see who's in the coffin. You want to read a gag from left to right. So the punchline is here on the right. Ooh, too big. Anyway. So that's what it's going to be. And it's going to be, first I'm going to do Hillary banging Bernie into the coffin. I haven't drawn Bernie very much. This is a Bernie that I was kind of happy with. So I'm going to think about that face, and I'm also going to look at his Google Images faces like I do whenever I draw somebody. But I'm not gonna have a good Bernie off the top of my head. I'm going to have to struggle and figure out how to draw Bernie. So you'll see a little bit of struggle here as I draw coffins today. Well, let's get going here. Well, I need to reset the camera. Let's do that. I guess that works. Alrighty, we'll get going here. Every time I start streaming again, I lose all of the settings on the camera, so I have to set everything up again. Pain in the butt. In case you're rejoining me, I just finished doing the Cruz, Kasich, Trump cartoon, and have not yet uploaded those to DarylCagle.com. Those will go up later today. And so let's look at my old coffin cartoon. Because I was not displeased with this layout. It's a good cartoon. I'm going to have a collection of Nails in the Coffin cartoons. probably should look at a page of coffins, huh? I don't know that I ever did any coffin research. Let's do that. Coffins. Well, there are lots of coffins. They all seem to have this kind of width at the shoulders, don't they? I think I didn't draw that before. Pine box. Zombie coffin don't have width at the shoulders, but typical coffin does have width at the shoulders. It's looking kind of unusual for them to have the curved tops like I drew as well. There's one curvy top. That's what I think of as a coffin. The long bar on the side, the curvy top, straight. I guess that's not the most typical coffin. That seems to be a more typical coffin. Hmm. Well, it's kind of a hassle to, there's Bernie. What else do I got here? Yeah, I think I don't really want to, do that width at the shoulders thing. I'm gonna give it a lip. I think I like the way that I drew it before. Oops. Here I am drawing. Somebody needs to tell me to switch the scene back. So, center. And I'm happy with this coffin. Another end over there. It's not really a hinged coffin now, is it? So I'm going to need enough space here to have the lid lift, but not look like it's lifted a lot. Then I like the roundness of it. Give it some roundness today rather than what I did last time around. Could have a second little ridge here. Okay. Those pencil lines should be light because I'm using the hard pencil here. Let's move that over. I guess that's good enough. Need that. Hey, the Phoebe writes, I'm back again. Never timed it to see you start on one of these. Very exciting. I'm actually online right now looking at getting some Duraline. Oh, you like the Duraline. Are you going to draw in pencil on Duraline, Phoebe? Phoebe, in case you don't know, is a brilliant artist who has a wonderful, wonderful line quality that I admire. And he streams here on Twitch. Someone that you should follow. Um, the key to Duraline, Phoebe, is you want to use a hard pencil. This 4H pencil, you can see how crummy it is for drawing on this slick hard paper, but on Duraline it draws like a number 2 pencil, and it is just really comfortable, and it gets a hard edge and a very black line, and since it is a harder pencil than most people are used to, it gives it's not that easy to smear as if you were using a softer pencil, but it is really quite deceptive on the Duraline in how it appears to be a soft pencil rather than a hard pencil. Phoebe writes, I draw on Duralar all the time with a similar surface, which I can't think of the name right now, and I'm curious if it's any better than Duraline. You know, I don't think I liked Duralar. That's white paper, right? White plastic paper. I think I was only happy with Duraline. And there were a couple of times when I ordered Duraline and it had a different texture than what I expected, which was not so good at picking up the line. And then when I bought it again subsequent to that, it was fine. So I don't know what to say. The ones that I've bought in pads have never been a problem. It's only been when I ordered them bulk and not a pad from Seth Cole that did not work out. But the pads have always been good. All right. That'll go there. This is going to have some cross-hatching that defines it as a boxy surface. So... Good, go try it. I like the look of Duraline. Here, this is, turn this into a paper commercial. This is my last drawing that I did of, Cruz and Trump and Kasich. And, you know, it's got a little bit of smudges on it, but I can just come back with my, if I remember where I put my kneaded eraser, I can just come back. And this is awfully easy to clean up. Look at this. Just oh, those are fingerprints on the back side because my table, whoop, my table's so dirty. And there's my microphone. Anyway, point is, it's very forgiving paper. There goes the microphone. Sorry about that. I know how loud that is. But what is so cool is that all these little light lines turn out to be black lines, and everybody thinks I draw in ink. And if I did draw in ink, I would draw really stiff. I hate having to make the commitment. Anyway, that was still in the scanner. So, this is going to be Hillary and Bernie. Let's start with Hillary. I like to give her big hips. That may be a little wrong because she's hips are here, spine goes that way. I still think in terms of being you know, maybe it is Duralar that I use. And Duraline was an older name for it. I don't remember. I don't have a pad to look at because I bought my stuff in bulk. Oh no, I want her back to go up so that she's got an arm here. She's tiny hands. I guess both Hillary and Trump have tiny hands, huh? Denril, that's what I'm thinking of. That was the old name for it that they gave up. Denril is the stuff I use. Very good, Phoebe. You know more about this stuff than I do. And it's the stuff I use. Before I had a big, I'm gonna need to extend this. Borden and Riley. No, I've got this is from Seth Cole. Let me type that. The stuff I use is from Seth Cole. Tell you what, I'll find a link for it. Yeah, this is what I use. Here. Seth Cole Duraline, that's what the pad looks like. I use 14 by 17. Yeah, you got it. Same page. We'd be cool. Okay, back to the drawing. I think it makes nice original art. They make a lot of claims about how their they're good for being archival quality. I'm gonna need to tape a spot. I ran out of room. Think perspective of her hand on her hammer. Cactus, thank you so much for following me. I do need the follows. Yeah, I remember this was a compromise I made with this position to try to get her, one that I did before when I drew Obama. This is my oldie that I'm looking at here. So we've got here. What's going to need to happen. It needs to go up like that. Here, 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 and here, here, here. Okay. So we'll do that. 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 Hand too close. I forgot about this being such a perspective thing. So now this one is wrong. That hand needs to come up. I think I'd kind of like to. Her legs are pretty stubby. And her feet are pretty small. Okay, Hillary face. You know, I'm not that good at Hillary, that I still need to look at Photoscrap. Let's do... Hillary Clinton images. And just in case you're wondering, this is what I'm looking at on my screen here. Hillary Clinton images. So that I, her hairstyle changes so much. And she does look a lot different, older than she did younger. Big change, I think, being her eyebrows. She had her eyebrows dealt with and was very effective in softening her. A sport coat. Hard to know what to give her for a top. You know she needs the pantsuit. I may scoot her back just a little bit. Let's make a note of that. Because I'm going to need more room here for nails. Okay, Hillary. I still give her extra heavy eyebrows because she had that when she was younger, and it still kind of defines who you think she is. Hello, Okomi. You can call me Hillary if you want. Her nose is kind of long. She doesn't ever really have her bottom lip go out like that. She could have a little bit of tongue. She's getting some bulldog jowls. just going to need some motion lines between the arms, huh? She wears some heavy mascara as well. She's done so much with her hair, you can kind of do what you want with it and not worry too much about it being wrong. Her hands are getting a bit obscured by the position here, but I kind of need this position. She'd be looking back at Bernie. Okay, Bernie. Bernie. I think I'm gonna need Bernie's hand. Bernie's head has to be about here, so I can have a little bit of his hair flowing out. Actually, his funny nose could be up like that. That's kind of funny. Kami, right? She needs to win all the remaining votes for like 65% to avoid a contested. What was the word? Contested convention. No, actually, she's already mathematically eliminated Bernie. But Bernie won't quit, which is why, which is the idea behind this cartoon. Bernie's eliminated, but he won't quit, and he's still a pain in the butt for her. She just can't seem to. Put all the nails in the coffin. So that is the point of this cartoon. He should be dead. Come on, hurry up and be dead. Jerk. I say that, but I'm going to be voting for Bernie. I know it will be shocking to some of you 11 people watching, but I'm also, if it's Trump versus Hillary, which it looks like it will be, I'm going to vote for Trump. I know how shocking that is. All right, I'm going to have to get Bernie right. You know, one of the interesting things about Bernie, this is another Bernie that I did over here that I was kind of happy with on this one. Which reminds me, Hillary's nose needs to be bigger than this, doesn't it? Comey writes, either candidate that's not owned by the establishment is fine for me. You're an agreeable fellow, Comey. Okay. So I've got to think about my Bernie Sanders. I think maybe I'm going to need to bring up another. Oh, I'm sorry. You got to remind me to go back to the drawings. I need to bring up yet another page, which will be Bernie Sanders images. See what those look like. Bernie Sanders is kind of difficult to draw because he's got this funky nose that defies perspective. Put him here in the corner. So, just in case you're interested, again, this is what I'm looking at on my screen to see how to draw Bernie Sanders. His head here is a little too big. His eyes relate to each other. I might want to fit two eyes in here. I think I can fit two eyes in. That way I can get the gimpy eye and the open eye. His left or right eye is gimpy. His right or left eye is round. Get that. And then his funny nose. What's interesting about the nose, I think, is its narrowness. It's a big commanding feature from the side, from the front it is not. And he's got that long upper lip. If I don't like this, I could always lift what I did from the previous Bernie. I'll print that out. Oh, got no paper in the printer. A second. No paper in the printer. Oh, I do have paper in the printer. All right, more paper in the printer. All right, let's print that. Comey writes, drawing doesn't give much hope for Bernie. I'm afraid not much hope for Bernie. It might be easier just for me to trace the other Bernie, because I already figured him out, and his head's in the right position, which is kind of unusual, seeing as I'm not too happy with how my Bernie's going. There he is. He needs to be 175%. Try this just a second. I got some angry email and letters to the editor for this Bernie cartoon. People didn't like it. They're touchy about their candidates they like this time around. People are pretty grouchy. Yeah, I'm just gonna go with my previous solution here, just because it's easier. And he's just at the right angle. Him there. Oh, that looks kind of, he looks kind of ghoulish, doesn't he? Is that a good size? Is he matching Hillary? He needs to be bigger, doesn't he? Let's give him just a little bit of a boost. Print him at, $185. He was just a little small there. All right, there he is. Lost the top of his head, but that's where it is. Yeah, people had all kinds of objections to this young women like Bernie better cartoon, which is an interesting phenomenon, how the young women like Bernie better. It really annoys the Hillary people, since they figure women should be her vote. Feel entitled to the women's vote, huh? Is he still small? Gonna get bigger when I draw him again. He could be bigger. Do I want to print that out again, or is that right? No, he needs to be bigger, doesn't he? All right. Let's do this again. All right, I'm just printing out a Bernie because I feel like I'm not going to do as good a caricature as I did of him before. And I've got him in just the right position. That looks better. It is better, isn't it? It's just the same. Bump it up a little bit more. Looking about Hillary sized, I think. Yeah, I was generally pleased with this Bernie. Of him at the bottom. A little bit of finger in front. Yeah, that looks good. Comey writes, "What bothers me is that Bernie has many of the talking points Dr. Paul had in 2012. Dr. Paul. Could be Dr. Rand or Dr. Ron. They kind of match on everything, don't they? His hand needs to be a little bigger. I do futz with every little thing. Comment I get is that I didn't know this would take this much time. I get that comment a lot. A little better. Ron is the father, and Rand is easy to remember because he's named after Ayn Rand. Move him down just a skosh. Down a little bit that way, moves Hillary a little bit that way, so that I can get the perspective on the top of the coffin better. So I will do that. That way I can also get better stuff going on with these nails. Yeah, let's do that. Move him down just a skosh. Move her butt back just a skosh. That way, that way. Good. So I'm going to be starting on Bernie because he's on the right and I draw from right to left. Then I can just I want to move her that way. Yeah, I've got room either way. Got these very asymmetrical eyes, which are fun. They're always at half mast, so I'm not sure I can have him look down at Hillary. He wouldn't look like himself if his eyes weren't at half mast. He's so asymmetrical in particular in the way that he is that he's funny to draw. All right, the eyebrows. He typically shows his bottom teeth as he's talking. When he smiles, his big upper teeth are so dominant that you forget that you're usually seeing his bottom teeth. And I give him a little bit more forehead. is wonderful. Okay, that was better. I used the solution I already had. Now, his hand is going to have to move down with him in tandem, I think. So I'll draw the hand before I move the paper. People are quiet today. Yesterday, when I was drawing Trump, people were chatty. Now I need to move him. Then I draw the coffin. Then I draw Hillary last because I'm going to want to reposition Hillary. So he was here, and I wanted him to go down a little bit and point that way. That's better. That gets the drawing to be a little cockeyed on the paper. I hadn't thought about. So I can bring that up to there. Probably should be using a ruler. Sometimes I draw things confident that I can do the lines right, and I did not. All my yellow pencil erasers are kaput. You want to see my pencil cup? Yellow eraser. Not there. There's one. Forget what I was erasing. This is what I was erasing. Let's use a ruler. Did I get that straight? Meh, straight enough. Straight. People have laughed at my ruler being so old. Young people don't use rulers these days. Comey writes, what is it with yellow pencils erasers? Are they better than other erasers? Well, I basically have two eraser options. I have my kneaded eraser, and then I have the yellow pencil eraser, which could be a hard plastic eraser. What's the difference between a soft and a hard eraser? The soft eraser is good for smudges, and the hard eraser is good for getting rid of thick, hard lines in a small area where you know just what you want, rather than general tone like the kneaded eraser. So basically two kinds of erasers, hard rubber eraser, kneaded eraser. It ain't rocket science. Bring back the ruler. I haven't decided where I'm putting Hillary here. I'm going to move Hillary back a little bit in this. I'm a mess today. Do that again. Something that people like to say to me a lot is, I can't draw a straight line. I don't know why people are motivated to say that, but I hear that a lot. So, use a ruler. Jeez, doesn't matter if you can't draw a straight line. like the yellow pencil erasers rather than using a big, thick, white or pink eraser. Because, because I can handle them like a pencil and get better control for erasing fine lines. Notice I turned the pencil there to make the line thinner on the top, because the light source I always think of as top left, although this one's not necessarily top left, I guess, since I just shaded this side of the coffin. Generally top. Comey writes, what's the most annoying thing you're told regularly? Oh, it's nothing too annoying. I guess the ones I get mostly that are kind of brainless are, oh, you've got so much to draw with the news lately. This is a great time to be a political cartoonist with so much going on. Of course, that's nonsense. It's got the same hole in the newspaper every day when there's a lot going on as when there's little going on. And cartoons aren't any better when there's a lot going on. The other one is, where do you get your ideas? Oh, and where'd you learn to draw like that? Should put those things on the nightbot, huh? Where do you get your ideas, Daryl? I could have it ask me that every few minutes. Where'd you learn to draw like that, Daryl? Local National Cartoonist Society chapter is funny. They have patches that we're supposed to wear on plaid leather jackets as our cartoonist chapter dress code. On the patches, it says in Latin, where do you get your ideas? I think that's funny. All these silent people lurk and watch. Don't say anything. Is that a nail in Hillary's mouth? Or her tongue? I had her tongue, but I may take the tongue out. Because it may not read clearly at a glance. So I'm not committed to that tongue. With this cross-hatching is to give it tone and dimensionality, show that it is the parallel lines make this a flat surface, flat vertical surface. Guess when you're hammering things in, you do have you keep the nails in your mouth, huh? That might be a complex concept to put across in a simple drawing. Getting busy around that little spot of Hillary. You hear some clunks and thunks. That's my neighbors building a house. They're very noisy. Giant, ugly house. I think that's the only kind of houses people want to build now. Giant McMansions. The more square footage they can fit onto a lot, the more money they can make out of their lot. Is announcing his Carly Fiorina choice right now. I'm not even sure I care enough about that to draw a cartoon. Okay. Now let's position Hillary on here. I wanted her to come back. She can be a little bit higher on the coffin and give us a little bit more. Well, maybe she just needs to tilt down a little bit more. Put her hand off a bit. No. I think that works. That's where she goes. She was a little bit off. So, I'm going to have to take a 5-minute potty and refresh my drink. No, those two are not related concepts, they just happen to coincide. And so I'm going to set the timer for 5 minutes and I'll be right back. Hang in there, I will finish this. All right, I'm back. Looks like most of you stuck with me. Back to work. Shmaze. That's the first time I've seen you here. Thanks for joining us, Shmaze. Hey, I need for you to follow. I do appreciate the follows. I have one new follow today. It is Rainbow Cactus. I missed that, I guess. Thank you for following Rainbow Cactus. Ah, the Phoebe. Thank you for the kind words. Well, I'll see you later, Phoebe. Hey, thank you again for the nice hosting. I do appreciate that. That was really very thoughtful. Yeah, I should be here drawing for a while. I'm going to draw a second coffin cartoon with Trump hammering the nails into Kasich and Cruz. Thanks again, Phoebe. She wears these funny tops. That don't have traditional lapels. not a very artful hand there. I think I might redo that. Kind of yucky looking hand. It would work on someone else, but Clinton's hands are really kind of diminutive. I think I need to be a little more tiny and subtle with her hands than I sometimes tend to do. So let's give that another shot. Excuse me. Excuse me. Coffin fit like Hillary. Bring up my Hillary page again. Just in case you're wondering what I'm looking at as I draw Hillary's face, I want to remember, get a sense of Hillary-ness as I draw. She can get pretty wide-eyed. So, Kutake bids, writes, why twitch? He can make videos and add on YouTube and get more viewers. That only works if you guys will follow. Don't have that many follows. That was the plan. Although, now that I've figured out how to do this stuff, which was a learning curve, I don't mind drawing live on Twitch. Used to it. In some ways, it makes me more efficient. No Red Ties writes, the Doom commercial is so you. I know you don't see it, but we all do. You don't, the Doom commercial, when you first turned it on, huh? Nice to see you here, No Red Ties. Thanks for coming back. Her hair doesn't look right. I'm going to have to futz with her hair a little bit. Writes, I love your pencil work. I lose so much subtlety when I go to ink and vector. Yes, I do when I go to ink as well. That's why I use the pencil. Something about going to ink, that sense of permanence stiffens me up. still looks bad. Her hair doesn't really do this flip thing either. Chuck's stuff. I haven't seen you here before. I need for you to follow. Got one follow today. This is my second cartoon. That needs to go this way. Hey, Chuck Stuff, thank you so much. That's very nice. She doesn't really have a part now. She's got her hair looking like it's a hat. Go with that hair, but it's not quite right, is it? The part is looking wrong. Because it doesn't have a part. Diaz Mata writes, 171,626 views and 322 follows. How is that even possible? I don't know. It sounds like a lot of views for so few follows, doesn't it? Okay, hammer. Gotta do the nails too. No Red Ties writes, we see you checking the monitor for the silence. Maybe she should be nailing it down on the world, not just Bernie. Thanks for the kind words, No Red Ties. Her hand placement on this hammer is wrong here, because I needed to get the hand up to show it behind her. Okay, nails. That one's wrong. And that one's wrong. Chuck Stuff writes, do you always use 4-H on vellum? I do. There are times when I will do a painting, but pretty rare these days. And I'm pleased with the pencil on vellum as original art. When people buy the art, they seem to be happy with the pencil on the vellum. It's a little bit gray, but not very gray. It has a kind of a pleasing look to it, I think. And it's supposed to be supposed to last forever when we're all dead and only the roaches are left. Should be fine. I've also got the TV on with CNN. Oh, and no, it's MSNBC behind me. Meet the Press Daily with Chuck Todd. I worked for MSNBC for quite a while. And they were very nice. Then they were taken over by Comcast, and everybody I worked with was laid off. I don't even know anybody there now. I worked with an editor and a business person. My business person is now business person for AP, and my editor is now the editor for marijuana.com, and my old head of everything at MSNBC, who used to be the head guy at Slate, the was in charge when I started off over there, the guy that brought me in, he's now the president of Cheeseburger Network. You know, the little kiddies that say, "I can have cheeseburger." So, all in all, a pretty accurate picture of where journalism is going these days, you know? From MSNBC to marijuana.com and I can have cheeseburger. And I have no publication of record now. I just draw from my own syndicate. Could have some nails that are farther in, huh? No Red Ties writes, "We're all here to watch him use the other end of the pencil, MSNBC and marijuana.com. Nice." Thank you for the kind words, No Red Ties. Do need to get more people watching. If any of you folks have any ideas on that, I appreciate it. My original idea here was that I wanted to be the streaming editorial cartoonist pioneer. you know, we represent so many editorial cartoonists, I thought that we could support other cartoonists in streaming, post them on the site when they stream, like you see I'm streaming now on Kegel.com. But I think I have not amassed enough audience to interest anyone in following my footsteps. She's probably looking finished, huh? Am I done with this one? I think I might be. Thank you. usually don't like to have my name come down to make the frame bigger. Looks like I did that. Okay, I think this is done. So, next question is how to proceed with the same cartoon with Trump squeezing Cruz and Kasich into the coffin. I may do a rough sketch on a piece of trace on top of this one. Might be better to color this one first and just get it out, because you never know what's going to happen. Bernie could withdraw tomorrow. Don't have a good idea for a Fiorina cartoon. I'm not even sure I'm motivated to draw that. Okay. Do I like this wrinkle here? It's fine. All right. There's always more that I can obsess over. All right, I think I'm done. I'm going to scan this and then come back and color it. Then I think I'm going to draw Trump and his cohorts tomorrow, because this is going to take me an hour to color. So thank you again for the kind words, no red ties. All right, so what's going to happen is I'm going to take another break and scan this. It's not in a very, not a very American style to draw with no words. It's kind of international, but I like the no words. Okay. I think we're good. So what I'm going to do is I think I kind of need another video for the color. So I'm going to sign off for probably 15 minutes and then come back. And then I will have this in the computer and I will color it. So, let's keep it in the same video. So I'm going to turn on the timer. So folks, keep hanging around and I'll be back. Hopefully it won't take as long as 15 minutes to get this scanned and into the computer. And I will color this puppy. So thank you for joining me, folks, and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. Let's get going here. Here you can see that I'm drawing on my Wacom tablet here in front of me. And that's what it looks like. Thanks for sticking around. So here I'm just cleaning up and assembling. This is why the pencil looks like ink. I bump up the brightness and bump down the contrast. I think that's looking about right. Skin was a little bit light. Six foot five, all right. Could be a little bit wider. Let's do that. That's a little better. All right, now I need to go in here and clean up. This is cartoonist housekeeping. Let's make this tidy. 16 quiet lurking twitchsters who have nothing to say. Nothing at all. Shop is laggy right now. I think streaming Twitch and running Photoshop at the same time is sometimes ambitious for my little Mac. Comey writes, she does have a scary look in her eyes in real life. You know, she does much better now that she has her eyebrows done. She used to have those thick, dark eyebrows that she has softened. But I still tend to draw them a little bit more harshly because she's a combination of the way that she actually looks now and the way that we remember her from before. You can't entirely forget before. It's an issue with Bill Clinton, you know, he's so skinny now and he looks pretty old. But we remember him being chubby and eating the McDonald's. I find it hard to draw him skinny. screwed his hair up a little bit. Fix Hillary's fingers a little bit. That was a little sloppy. Getting obsessive. Always get obsessive right at the point where it's time to quit. too obsessive. This is going to be colored. Let's save this for now. We will go back. Oops. Let's save as CMYK. And we'll make that 400 dpi. Silent folks. All right. Okay, there's CMYK. Let us select all. Comey writes, you miss listening to the radio while working? Yes, that's a concession I've made to this Twitch streaming. All kinds of interesting things are happening on the TV behind me. I usually listen to Fox News, CNN, and MSNBC. Okay. I forget. Did I make that bitmap? I think I did. Do I need to do that again? In order to clean it up and get it. Get rid of any grays. Photoshop needs to think. All right, I think I'm okay. So let's select all of the black. I'm going to delete it. And we'll fill. That is not nearly dark enough. 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's see how dark that is. 100. Okay. Let's select the inverse. Delete that. fill again. That took away some of the black. Select inverse again. Look how much darker that got. Why the hell does Photoshop insist on graying out the black? Alright, I think that's good. Top layer must multiply. Bottom layer will be all white. Fill 100%. Okay. Now, I had some breakfast crumbs on my shirt there. All right. This is ready to roll. Image size goes to 400. All right. What color should this be? They'll be flesh toned. That'll be a brown coffin. Gray hammer, ochre handle. Her suit can be anything, probably purple. If it is purple and that's brown, maybe the background should be yellow. All right, let's do that. It's not a bad yellow. See how that looks. Didn't realize that was on the white layer. Let's put in some texture. Yellow bright come through in spots. Well, that's kind of fine for background, I guess. Let's try doing some things that we know that we need. Let's go with flesh. Three, 22, 22, 100%. looks a little bit purple because it's next to the yellow. And I have that little bit of brown in it, that little bit of cyan in it that makes it a brown. Cyan is bumping it up to look purple. Is it really going to look that purple? All that yellow? Let's go with 2 cyan. Looks the same. Zero cyan. See what we think of that. Remember to handle the hammer in that hand correctly. Drew the hand on top of the hammer handle. Everyone's so quiet. Nothing to say. Coloring is so mesmerizing. All right, let's give them a little bit of light flesh. That'll be poor Sanders, right? It's Kitty Pals. Kitty Pals, have you followed yet? I need the follows. That's gonna soften. Let's give them some light. Howling Wolf UA, thank you for following me. I appreciate that very much. I do need the follows. Kitty Palace writes, a lot going on this week. Weren't you just drawing yesterday? Yes, and this morning before I started this cartoon, I colored the drawing that I did yesterday. And later today, that should be up on DarylCagle.com. So you can see what you missed in the video. Hey, thanks again, Howling Wolf UA. I do appreciate the follow. You must come back and bring all your friends and watch me draw cartoons all the time. I must say that drawing on Twitch has changed the way I work in the respect that I used to multitask. And I'd have like 5 or 6 projects going at the same time, and cartoons might take me 2 or 3 days because I would keep putting them off, doing a little bit and hopping on to the next part. And now I finish them in one sitting because it's a reasonable thing to do in a video, finish this stuff in one sitting. Red Ties writes, the guy in the red shirt is supposed to die before the first commercial. Yes, I have gotten comments about how I'm a Star Trek red shirt. The reason I wear this red shirt is because it's easy on the chroma key with the blue screen behind me. And if I wear the same red shirt every time, then I can do something with these videos, edit them together somehow, and not look like I'm changing from one to the other. So I just have a shirt I put on every time I do streaming. Probably pretty stinky by now. Nah, it's good. I can wear it another couple months before I wash it. I don't get sweaty while I draw. My drawing shirt. guess the next thing to do is the coffin, since it's going to be one big clear color. Howling Roof Wolf UA writes, saw your Obama kiss butt cartoon last week. Did that spark any controversy? Thought it was spot on. Thank you for the kind words on that. No, I didn't hear a friggin' thing about that cartoon. It was just nothing. Nobody cared. Butts are passe these days. That man Walker, oh, it's nice to see you back. Do you think it's fishy that whenever there are voter ballot errors that Hillary just happens to win? Nah. Hillary's kicking butt. I don't like Hillary because I want to, I think she's too eager to jump into wars. But I don't question her honesty as Donald Trump does. Go down to here. Okomi writes, I saw a very similar version with a long line of ass kissers, all of them EU presidents. Ass kissing is a great tradition in editorial cartoons. Drew her hand on top of the hammer there, but I certainly did. All right, let's make the hammer 0, 0, 0, 30. Let's give it a little bit of blue. Good hammer color. Put it there on top of the flesh. Okomi writes, now that I remember, I think it was Erdogan's. Erdogan likes to throw cartoonists in jail. That's a little too dark. That's better. Sue cartoonists. He is intolerant of being insulted. Kind of a evil ally, huh? I don't like that so many of our allies are so nasty. I think we can do without them. I don't think we need Saudi Arabia to be an ally. We're so busy helping Iraq. They're no ally. All right. Let's do this coffin color. I'm going to do that on layer 4. And let's make that. It's got no cyan in it, it's just got K. Let's make it 20, 18, 30, 0, 40, 36, 55. Oh, that looks kind of good. May come out pretty purpley, can't be sure. That'll help. All right, I'm going to go with this for coffin color. So the neighbors stopped banging on their house building. Now the wind has picked up. I'm hearing whooshes of wind. I've got to come back and dry Hillary's clothes, so losing those edges doesn't matter. And I'm going to have to draw Bernie's white hair on top of that coffin, so that edge doesn't matter. I was going to make her pantsuit purple. All right, let's give this some texture. No red ties, right? As he's getting nailed, Burning Man is still speaking up with those eyes and mouths you gave him. The hill face speaks for itself as well. Yoda feels great fear in her. Fear leads to anger. Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering. But still, there's something, someone wearing a red tie. Well. I don't think you've ever seen me draw a red tie while you've been watching here. No red ties. Wolf points out that Trump likes red ties. Red ties don't work well in cartoons because they're little focal points and draws your eye to the bright color. Of what you want to do in a cartoon and in coloring, well, not just cartoons, but just about anything, and when you do art, is you want to control the importance of different elements in the design by what you color them. You don't want your art to look like a bunch of M&Ms where the eye goes to no particular place. Good enough. Oh, you like the flesh colors, huh? Howling Wolf. I don't do very fancy flesh colors because this is for lousy printing. drawing like this, I forget forget where I put things in these color layers. I shouldn't be doing that there. I should be doing it here. I don't have to worry about keeping in the lines because I'm underneath the coffin. Comey writes, any words on the coffin? No! Cartoons with no words are better. Hey, Skalaz1, thank you so much for following. That's very nice. Oops. There's a button on my Wacom stylus. Right here. See the button? As I draw, when I bump the button, that brings up the menu that I never use from the button. I never use the button. Button is just a pain in the butt. You press the button and you touch, and that brings up the menu. Maybe I should use that. I do go to that menu. Never even programmed all these buttons on the side of the Wacom tablet. I haven't gotten into the habit. I've seen some guys use Wacom tablets with all these button presets that are, they look like they do amazing things. All these commands happen, you don't know how they happened. But I have not ventured to do so. guys think this cartoon needs words? Comey writes, I'm convinced after every primary vote, she thought this one will be the last nail. This time he will quit. Yeah. Oh, no red ties. You're looking back over my my archive, huh? Looking for red ties? I'm sure I've done lots of red ties. Hillary's suit. Oh, I should do the... What else did I do here? Oh, I did the hammer. Okay, let's do a new layer. We'll put it here. Bump that up a little bit. And let's... Lighten up the hammer path. No red ties, right? She has several red suits. You know, it's Nancy Reagan that was famous for, wearing red suits so much. All right, purple. Let's put Hillary's suit here. That doesn't want to rename. We'll call it 25. 36, 0, 0. Looks like a good Hillary color. Chuck Stuff, nice to see you're still here. You've been quiet since you followed. Work. Why didn't that work? Because I haven't selected the right tool. That's too small. That's too big. That's the menu I would get if I press my button. Excuse me. It's not 100%, is it? That's a pain in the butt. Let's make it a little lighter. Kind of liked it that light. Excuse me. Back over this to get the color to be consistent. Hey, lock on 5500. Thank you so much for following. That's very nice. I need those follows. If you're new here, you should know that all my past cartoon archive, since I've started live streaming on Twitch, is posted with the YouTube videos of my live streams on darylcagle.com. You can see the past ones, watch the old streams. They are so easy to do. Not sure I like this break in her hair that's happening here. Also, the background color matches Hillary's hair color. So I should deal with that. I'm not quite sure how. Right. Let's give her a little texture. Hey, silent concert. Thank you so much. For some reason, people are finding me now. Oh, the right shoe. Thank you, Okomi. Forgot to do the stinking right shoe. Let's give her a little dark texture, too. Purple is fun, it's a regal color. Hillary's kind of regal, huh? West Coast allergies, I think. It's gotten suddenly very windy, and I think it's kicking up junk. The trees are all wiggling around, going whoosh. Something that happens here. Ooh, that looked bad. Let's go back to the white. White it down a little bit. Put a little bit more texture in a few more spots. Better. Okomi writes, I was betting you lived in Australia. Weird animals over there. I don't sound like I live in Australia. Okay, let's give her a little bit of, let's add a new layer here, darker purple tone, we'll go a little bit lighter. All right, well, Comey, you just need to go to darylcagle.com. Go watch the oldies. You can watch them at double speed on YouTube. I like that double speed option. That's 100%. Wasn't thinking about that. Hundred percent is kind of more bold than I should be. She needs. Well, it's pretty clear, if you watch me frequently, that I put off the decisions until I have to make them. And I haven't done the ground. Where did I do this? Jeez, I forget where I did everything. It was on this layer. You know, you're pretty safe with gray. Let's go with gray and texture. That can be the ground. Let's give it another ground layer in case I don't like it. New layer. And that can go behind the coffin. Bump this up. Steve Sack cartoon on Cruise Kasich deal is hilarious, huh? I'm a big Steve Sack fan. Oof. What the hell? good enough for the ground. I don't want the ground commanding much attention. All right. Now I put off Hillary's hair. So I didn't know what to do about Hillary's hair. Howling Wolf. I just finished my Cruz Kasich Alliance cartoon, but I have not posted it yet. I sent it out to newspapers, though. Oh, editor's pick on the front page, huh? My editor does a good job of picking. If any of you have never visited Kegel.com, you should go there. That's our big editorial cartoon site. So Howling Wolf is my Twitch pop-up working on Kegel.com. I haven't looked today. I turned it on. Okay, I think that's all I'm going to do to her hair. Her hair is just the same color as the background. I don't know that there's that much to do to it. I think maybe I'm done. Still got the pencil on my hand. Yeah, I would say this is done. I'm gonna send this puppy out. Ah, the Twitch pop-up got you to come over here. Oh, very good. So are you not a regular Twitch user? Is this your introduction to Twitch? I think maybe a little bit more junk going on down here. Okay, this is done. I'm going to... Well, I still have to do the black and white version. Save as... Let's put that... Well, I just need to save this way it is. And let's save as... In the... Cartoon ones here. This will be 1117. Oops, I want to save it without layer. Save as. And that's going to be a JPEG. Quality 9. Let's see how big that is. No, 3.3 megs. That's okay. So, now, what's this going to look like in black and white? Let's give it a try. We'll save as. Gray. Okay. Now let's try the grayscale and see what we get. Don't merge. Okay. It's just like everything I do comes out dark and flat. So, oof, sore butt from sitting here so long today. Let's go in and lighten it up. Opacity 35, I guess that's okay. It's looking better. Let's lighten up Bernie. Let's lighten up the rails here. Howling Wolf writes, I didn't know you do two versions of each cartoon. Well, you know, newspapers still mostly print in black and white, and if I don't do this, they just grayscale the color cartoon, and it doesn't have the nice, thoughtful grayscale that only takes me a few minutes to do So I give a separate grayscale version. Many of our cartoonists do separate grayscale versions. I found that if I, Druid Pack 45, right, so is that Bernie Sanders and Hillary Clinton? It is indeed, and Druid, I need the follows, so since you are new here, please give me a follow. Okay, let's bring this down a little. Bit more background texture, don't I? Let's try that. I'll do that back here in the ground layer. That's all right. Getting where I put this other stuff on there. I'm just going to need to do this on top, huh? All right, we'll do it on top. Helps. Needed a little bit more of that for the black and white. Black and white needs lightening up in its darkening, flattening stuff that happens from the color, and it needs a little bit more bold texture. Oh, Comey, thank you for the kind words. So I think we've got this one finished. Let's right foot again in the grayscale. I think the right foot's okay. Let's go with opacity 100%. And let's deal with some of this background, because remember I put all this yellow in the background, which is going to be a very light gray, so what I need to do is make sure that the edges of it are going to be textured out to white, because if they aren't, I can get a bunch of scum on here that's not visible on the screen. Here, let's do a little bit of this too. okay. I think she's looking good in black and white now. Howling Wolf writes, do you go look at the newsprint version to see how it comes out? Well, I never know when it's going to be printed, but my hometown newspapers are pretty good about printing my cartoons, and sometimes I am horrified by the things I forget. So if I happen to see them, it's when I see them. Never know when something's going to get published. Right leg a little too dark, even in its shadow, right? Soft top. Soft top, I haven't seen you here before. You mean this part here, soft top, that bothers you? I can do that. I can get a piece of that shoe. Let's give that a little bit of that. There, that's a little bit closer to the other shoe. Does that please you more? It's okay. Thank you, Soft Top. Soft Top, you must follow! I haven't seen you here before. Okay, this is the black and white version. This is going to be done. I'm going to flatten, see if I can save this as a TIFF. Always better to save as a TIFF because TIFF files don't lose anything. You lose when you save as a JPEG. And some clients complain about TIFFs because they're used to getting everything in RGB format from AP. And they say, our publishing system wants it to be RGB JPEG. That looks good. So, I'm going to send this puppy out. That is this one. And then the other one is this one. Following for 3 months, Soft Top, you're one of the first ones here. I just don't ever see you talking. All right. It is this in color and this in black and white. And you can see I had to do quite a bit to make the black and white work. It's rather different than the color. But, you know, you don't perceive that things are so much of a flat, dark value in color because you're seeing the colors, and the colors differentiate things. But in this, it took a good deal of lightning parts to make it work in black and white. If I hadn't have done that, they'd have grabbed the color and just gone with that in black and white, and it would have looked lousy. And if I found that when I give them just the line art, which I prefer, the nice just black lines with no gray tone, that the editors will always go to the color cartoon and grayscale it and print that instead of the line art, because for some reason they see the grayscale as better than the line art, and they don't want to go with the line art. And what can I say, very frustrating, because, you know, the line art versus the grayscale is kind of like a sailboat versus a powerboat. You know, sailboats are elegant, powerboats are what people like, and I go for the elegant and they go for the powerboat. And what can I say, anyway, I may draw Trump trying to hammer nails in the coffin of Cruz and Kasich tomorrow. I'm not sure, because I may have a better idea tomorrow. So, but if I don't, I can draw the same one for Cruz and Kasich. It works. Hey, thank you so much for joining me today. I should host somebody else. Let me take a look. Who should I host? You guys suggest someone? Is there somebody who's excellent at drawing, who's got a nice following there? Judas Mata. I'm taking a look at Twitch now to see who else is good over here. Click on drawing. I'm not a fan of the anime, and there's so much darn anime.
Great attitude, pal. Thanks for dropping by and hanging out with the crew here at Second Entertainment Incorporated.
Phew. That was the sound coming through. I'm looking here for someone that I want to host in the drawing section. I'm not seeing anybody I want to host. Me look at painting. I like Val Dudes. I don't see him on right now. You guys have any? Oh, hello, Party Hat Giraffe. Nice to see you here. Give me a follow. I need a follow. Flipping through to see who to host as I just finished my cartoons. And, oh, there I am. 19 viewers in the. Oh, this is just general creative section. Oh, I found myself. I'm not sure who I want to host. You guys not giving me any suggestions. Drawing Photoshop. Let's try Photoshop. Cat textures. Boy, that's the way to get more people watching you on Twitch. Kitties. Do kitties. Digital art. I got nothing. Unless you guys have a better suggestion, I think I'm just gonna sign off. Don't find people that do similar stuff to me. Lots of manga. Oh, you share my stream on Twitter, Judas Mata. That's very nice of you. Thank you. Well, truly outrageous. I guess she looks okay. Maybe I'll give her drawing subs, drawing illustration. Ooh, intended for mature audiences. She's kind of funky. I think people follow her because she's a cute girl. I'm not seeing anybody to host. You guys aren't suggesting. My numbers are dropping, so it's not really an issue. Creative soul. Let's look at her. She looks pretty nice. I see a trend on Twitch for people to want to follow other people who are cute girls. So let's do that. Let's host the Dusty Factor. She looks kind of nice. So, hey, thank you, folks. I'm gonna go host somebody else's stream. So let's slash host the Dusty Factor. And our Party Hat Giraffe writes, "What kind of people am I looking to host? Someone who draws nicely in a way that's not anime, that's got a little bit of compatibility with the kind of stuff that I do, is what I was looking for. Not really finding it, but this gal looks like she's doing a nice drawing, so I will send folks to her. She's got a very exciting background going on. So anyway, hey, thank you folks all for coming today, and thank you for all the kind words, and I'll see you next time. And that will be the end of my recording today. Thank you so much for joining me, and join me next time when we have another nice cartoon to draw, which should not be too long.